Hi friends. Welcome to the new learning video on Pharmaguideline. Today we shall discuss operational qualification. Operational qualification is a critical step in the validation process for pharmaceutical manufacturing equipment, systems, or processes. It is a documented evidence-based process that ensures that the equipment, system, or process is operating as intended, meeting predefined specifications, and is suitable for its intended use. OQ is typically performed after installation qualification and before performance qualification as part of the overall validation process, often referred to as IQ, OQ, PQ of equipment. Equipment may be tested during OQ for qualities such as using an expected and acceptable amount of power, or maintaining a certain temperature for a predetermined period of time. Operational qualification of equipment follows a specific procedure to ensure the thoroughness of the tests and the accuracy of the results. The protocol must be detailed and easily replicated, so that the equipment can be tested multiple times by different testers. This ensures that the results of the tests are reliable, and do not vary from tester to tester or vary throughout the manufacturing process. Now, let us understand the key steps to perform the operational qualification. There are 6 key steps. Verify equipment or system functionality. OQ aims to ensure that the equipment or system functions according to its intended design and operational specifications. This involves verifying that all components and subsystems of the equipment or system are installed, calibrated, and functioning correctly and that they meet predefined acceptance criteria. Validate critical process parameters. OQ includes verifying and validating critical process parameters, such as temperature, pressure, time, speed, and other relevant parameters, to ensure that they are within the predefined acceptable ranges. This helps to ensure that the equipment or system is capable of consistently producing the desired quality product. Verify software and automation systems. If the equipment or system being qualified involves software or automation systems, OQ includes verifying and validating the software to ensure that it is installed correctly, functioning as intended, and meets predefined specifications. This may involve testing software functionality, data integrity, security features, and other relevant parameters. Document and record results. OQ requires documenting and recording the results of the qualification activities, including test protocols, test data, and reports. This provides documented evidence that the equipment or system has been qualified and is operating according to the predefined specifications, which is essential for regulatory compliance. Identify and address deviations. During OQ, any deviations or discrepancies from the predefined specifications or acceptance criteria are identified and addressed through investigation, corrective actions, and documentation. This ensures that any discrepancies are appropriately resolved, and the equipment or system is brought into compliance with the predefined specifications. Review and approval. OQ activities are typically reviewed and approved by qualified personnel, such as validation experts, quality assurance personnel, and other relevant stakeholders, to ensure that the qualification activities have been performed correctly and that the equipment or system is suitable for its intended use. A link to download the sample operational qualification protocol is given in the description of this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Thanks for watching this video.